Titled Numerical Investigation of Melting of Nanoparticle-Enhanced. Please check your comments.
Thank you, dear chairman. And thank you to the faculty, thank you to the organizing committee for this nice conference. I'm Muslum Arici from the University of Turkey. And in the name of my colleagues, I would like to present our study. I will start with the introduction, then I can describe the problem. I will show how we will need the results, and then I will go to the results group to discuss. And then I will finish with conclusion. Thermal energy, most of you actually know it, but I just, you know, I would like to start from this point, can be stored in the form of sensible heat or latent heat. Latent heat thermal energy storage can provide higher energy density in the small storage pool because of the latent heat. You know, you don't have to increase the temperature so high. And that's why it's used very common in many applications, such as solid thermal applications, thermal measurements for electric devices, air conditioning systems, and etc. However, there's a main problem in these applications, which is low conductivity of PCMs. And due to that reason, the melting or solidification process can take longer time, and which reduce the application of this to industrial products. And nanotechnology, test nanotechnology, now we can use nanofluids. Nanofluids actually is a component of the nanoparticles and PCMs. So we can use the thermal conductivity, and therefore we can increase, we can improve the internal characteristics of the PCMs. And in this problem, we use proper bags and we disperse with aluminum oxide. As you see in this slide, the conductivity of aluminum oxide is progressive, and even for the solid state of the carbon is 0.21, which is 180 times less than that of the aluminum oxide. However, we cannot increase the volume fraction of the nanoparticles because we will increase the viscosity also. And in this study, we investigate. There's a cavity like that one, and cavity is filled with PCMs. From one side we are heating, and from the other side is we are cooling. And both these temperatures are constant. So the high temperature, low temperature, and all other walls are considered to be ideal. We also consider the orientation of the geometry. So in the second case, we will heat the cavity, the enclosure from the bottom, and we will cool from the top. Specific heat is not very dependent on temperature, decreases by dispersing nanoparticles. And then it also decreases by adding, dispersing nanoparticles in the cell. Viscosity increases significantly, which is another very important parameter, because when you increase the viscosity, the movement of the fluid will be more difficult, you need more energy. So we have to do the same, there's a trade-off between conductivity and viscosity. We increase the conductivity, but on the other hand, we increase viscosity also. So we have to see that which parameter is more significant. That's actually one of the aim of this study.
It takes more than 3 weeks to just reach 30% of the melting time.
So for each case, you have to wait 35 days. At first, I would like to present the case of heating from site and low pressure of one person. In the beginning of the battery, for the time of 100 seconds, the PCM is not really close to the hot wall as we expected. And as time increases for the time of 10 minutes, as you see in this view, the valve liquid is rising out along the hot wall and it follows the valve and then it falls down along the solid interface of the PCM. And it falls at the triangular shape. But time is further increases, let's say 20 minutes. The sense is not more in the top of the enclosure, and even in the end of the upper hour, we cannot have the distance here due to the viscosity and also the low conductivity. You cannot, and that will be clearly seen in the digital structure. Here we see that the temperature gradients are present at this point, but here is still working. So at first, actually, we want to see that how we need to have the whole PCM in the enclosure, but then we realize that actually it will take a lot of time, so we change our approach. Okay, we said, okay, let's compare all the cases for the upper hour. For the case of heating from bottom, we heat from here. At first, in the first stage of the mapping, 6 cells of the distance are called parallel cells, are also. And after a certain time, let's say 10 minutes, these cells are merged into the big cells, and finally only 2 cells are observed. And as time increases, these 2 cells, it remains 2, the number of cells. But the size of cells are enlarged. You can see here that the mat is rising out, and it turns left, and other ones is on the right. But you can see that it almost covers the whole cavity, not like the heating from the side. Here we want to show that the mapping works for the different times, for the 100 seconds, 600, 20 minutes, and half an hour. And then hit it on the button, maybe like that. As you see, the difference between the pure PCMs and nano-enhanced PCMs are more significant for the case of hitting from button. That will be more clearly seen in this figure when you compare liquid fraction for the different times, the instantaneous liquid fraction, let's say. We just want to zoom this part because in the early stage of melting, the main interest of mechanism is conduction, and there is not much differences, actually, there is no differences in the heating from the side or from bottom. But by dispersing nanoparticles, I don't know if you can see here, by decreasing the volume fraction of the nanoparticles, the liquid fraction also increases. But as time increases, because the convection currents within shape, the difference between the orientation of the cavity will be very important. And as you see, heating from the below is much, the liquid fraction for this case is much higher than that of the heating from the side. And the difference between the effect of the nanoparticles is also more significant for the case of the heating from below. This is the pure PCM, and this is 1% of the pure PCM, so 3% of the PCM, and this is 1% of the nanoparticles dispersing in the PCM. It's also very significant. At first, you may expect that by increasing the nanoparticles, the heat fraction also increase. But that wasn't the case in our study. when we disperse one person of the nanoparticles increase in this sense, yes, the diffraction increases, but when it increases further, let's say from 0 to 3%, it decreases slightly due to the viscosity, because viscosity also increases. And the increase in viscosity is much more conservative than the one in the conductivity. So in this table, we would like to show the compare the matter fraction for the sum matter fraction, and we compare the how many seconds you need to issue this value. For the 20% of the matter fraction, as you see, for the pure PCR, you need around 558 seconds. But when you use 1% of the nanoparticles in the PCR, it reduces to 192. But when you increase further, the decrease is not so significant, and you pay only 509. So the performance, the improvement will be like 9%. For the heating for the bulb, the improvement is higher, is around 50% for the same, matter fraction, and 10% for the 3% of the nanoparticles. And you can see from this graph, so the heating from slag is not possible to reach the 80% of the matter fraction in half an hour. And then we compare how much energy can be stored during this time. As you see, when the soup line is pure PCM, and when we increase the nanoparticles of the fraction, it also increases the energy stored.
Due to stronger commercial works.
And that was the most present for the nanotechnology research compared to the field research. At the early stage of the planting, because it has a gas mass conduction, there was no differences. But when the convection currents are offset, you can see that the planting force for the outburst of nanoparticles is higher than that of the inburst of the nanoparticles. And the source energy is much higher for the heat of the heat from the bottom compared to the heat of the heat from the side. And with the increase of temperature, the effort of nanoparticles to the diffraction diminish for the higher time mapping and for the case of the heat from the bottom for our side.
Right, another question, I think it's personal.